你现在看到的是世界上最大的单叠射电望远镜，它被称为天眼，位于中国西南部山区。
And that is by far the most sensitive radio telescope in the world. I first went there while they were putting the first few things on the ground, and it was amazing to see how quickly in China you'd come back a year later and the whole dish would be built.
天眼的核心是一个多波束接收器，由澳大利亚科学家设计和建造。中国选择与澳大利亚合作，是因为澳大利亚在新州偏远地区有帕克斯射电望远镜的经验。
The Parkes Radio Telescope is by far one of the greatest telescopes in the world. It's been upgraded many, many, many times, so it keeps getting upgraded. It's not a 60-year-old telescope. The most recent upgrade was just a couple of years ago with a very wideband receiver system that allows us to observe the radio waves over a much wider bandwidth than any other telescope on the Earth.
帕克斯对戴什博士有着特殊意义。他第一次访问这里时还是一名国际学生。
I mean, the second you see the 64-meter big telescope there with wonderful weather, blue sky, I was really shocked. I thought this is the way to do astronomy.
后来他回到澳大利亚，在 George Hobbs 的指导下完成了他的博士学位，然后在西悉尼大学接受了一个教职。他研究的重点是快速旋转的中子星，也就是所谓的脉冲星。帕克斯射电望远镜探测到的脉冲星比世界上任何其他设施都要多。
Radio astronomy in Australia is really strong. The experience and expertise here are really the most attractive for students in China.
这在一定程度上要归功于像 Eli Sadler 教授这样的科学家们所付出的努力。三十多年来， Sadler 教授一直走在天体物理学研究的最前沿。他的团队利用西澳的平方千米阵探路者射电望远镜发现了一个50亿年前的星系。
Now, 5 billion years ago, the Earth didn't exist. So in the time that that signal's been traveling to us from this galaxy, the sun has formed, it's made planets, the Earth has settled down, it's got oceans, life has evolved, we've got a technology, we've built telescopes, and there we are just in time to catch this signal.
Sadler 教授7年前开始定期与中国科学家合作。他说，国际合作对于理解我们的宇宙至关重要。
I think one of the great things aboutworking collaboratively with people is it allows you to build up the trust and the common interests that allow you to make advances in science.
Astronomy is a very collaborative science. You can't just do your own research simply on your own.
It's about actually exchanging your idea with different people, different background, different expertise. If we don't have that, we are not doing the best science.